I'll quickly introduce myself. My name is Dushan Shreya, and I'm the CEO of iKit. Really, who we are at iKit, we are a transformational technology solutions company. What we do is we target governments and businesses, and we deliver high-quality strategy execution services. So why strategy execution? Because making a strategy work is really the most important part of a strategy, rather than just having a strategy. How we do this? We do this using world-class technology and best practice methodologies, and of course quality support. So we are reiterating pretty much all that has been said in the morning by all the speakers. And I think we really believe that every organization has the potential to succeed when they successfully create and execute their strategy. Now, most organizations already have a strategy, but execution is the key. So what I'm very quickly going to cover, and I've been told to push it along very fast because we are running out of time, so I'll really blow through this. Strategy 101, what is strategy? Why do we need a roadmap for strategy? What are the common challenges that we face? Milestones on the strategy map and the roadmap. So this is the roadmap which we've been using for the last 14 years, and one of our biggest customers here is the UAE government. And of course, if we have time, we'll go through an example. So if you go through strategy, you talk about going from point Y to point Z. So if you talk about where we are today, we are in 2015. And we want to reach 2020. So let's say we have big plans for the UAE Expo, and either you have what is called a low-plan plan, so you're here and you're always be here, which most people don't have, or you have a strategy whereby you have some alternate plans and you have some goals, and these goals may be either written or unwritten, but you know, pretty much every organization does have goals. Now, although you have a strategy and a plan, there are many obstacles on the way to strategy. So you will have, you know, new competition, you will have regulation, you will have political instability. So even with a strategy in place, you know, it is quite challenging to meet your goals. And you know, most organizations, when you talk to them and they ask them, they are so focused on operations that they don't really talk about strategy. So what happens if you don't have a strategy in place? You want more customers, you want more, you know, revenue, you want more profits, but without a strategy, it's pretty much like doing the same things over and over and expecting different results. So that's not really going to happen. So, if coming back to the point, like I said, most businesses, they do strategy at the last 10 minutes of their meeting. They talk profits, operations, and, you know, the business plan what they create are, and I'm a chartered accountant, so I have been guilty of doing this. And I'm a CFO of Freya and Protect. So I have been guilty of saying my budget is 20% more than last year. And my costs are 10% less than last year. And, you know, pretty much doesn't work. And we found that really what we were doing was not meet the strategy at all. So when I came to this company now 20 years back, for the first 3 or 4 years I was CFO of Freya and Protect, I found a gap. So I started my, what I call an adventure into strategy, and at that time there was a big pull from the UAE government to do strategy execution. So you heard of the Dubai 2021 plan, the Abu Dhabi 2030 plan, so we've been helping the government and different government entities, some of which I'll show you at the end. They've actually, we've helped them for the last 14 years to execute their strategy in the country. But coming firstly to the need for a roadmap. So why do we need a roadmap in the first place? Okay. Every organization follows many frameworks, and we've heard about some of these frameworks in the last, you know, couple of hours. You have strategy management based on balanced scorecard. So I have presented along with Robert Kaplan and Norton on the balanced scorecard over the last 5 or 6 years here in the region. You also talk about departmental performance. This is something which everybody has. Which department? How are they performing, as we mentioned. Then we also look at process management. So process management, you talk about, let's say, a customer performance and a customer process. Again, banking, telecom, we're talking about the process management. You also talk now about things which can go wrong. So many organizations today have created a risk management process. Now, this risk management may be something they look at on Excel, or something the CEO has in his mind, or something which is there, but every organization has risks, and we look at the risks. And finally, we heard about quality management. We heard about how people do ISO for the sake of a certificate. But then many organizations are ISO certified. So you have now a multiple systems that you have, and a multiple software tools to support these processes. So when you as a CEO or you as a head of the department, what do you look at? Are you going to look at the ISO system? Are you going to look at the banking system? What are you going to look at to give you that single source of truth to be able to take that one single decision? You also have different sections or different owners, different reporting formats which are there available. And the key challenge is ensuring that they all fit together. So if you have a customer service initiative, is your customer process correct? Are your customer risks addressed? Can anybody look at it on a sort of a 360 degree for one particular objective? And then is customer service, you know, is that your key strategy of the organization, or is market share the key strategy of the organization? It could differ from organization to organization. So coming to common challenges, and this is really the scenario in most organizations today, okay? You ask yourself the following questions. Do you have a clearly defined strategy? As we saw, as you pointed out, you have a strategy, is it shared? Maybe it's not shared. So it's clear to you, is it clear to the rest of the organization? Is it communicated to the entire organization? Do you have policies and procedures which are then linked to strategy? You might have them, somebody's creating them for ISO, but they may not really be linked to your strategy. What about aligning the processes with your strategy? Let us say from a telecom company and I want market share for a new SIM card, what is my activation process? Does it give me activation within 4 hours of application? Are my processes geared up for that? In banking, credit cards, on approval, am I going to get it within 24 hours? So your processes need to be backed up to ensure that you walk the talk. And that depends on your strategy. Do you have a system to identify your process risks and implement controls? So again, your credit card process. Have you bought all the documents? Are you issued a credit card to a guy who's at risk? Okay. Are your roles and job descriptions linked to your process? Do you have the proper staffing for your process? So a lot of questions when you look at it purely from a top-down strategy angle. And then are your processes performing? We spoke about key performance indicators, key result areas. So you can have these linked to your process also. So is your process performing as desired? So this is your typical situation. Okay? So you have a strategy, it's there, and then you say, now we have to identify processes, your strategy is on PowerPoints and Excel, and you have process management now, because you define processes. And then now we get into quality management, because you want to get the ISO certificate. That's again on Excel, Visio, and you have your quality management certificate. Somebody's looking at risks. And then, you know, which processes to improve? Are they related to your strategy? Okay. How do you ensure that you keep doing the right things? That's what your quality management is. Are you looking at the right type of risks? How does it affect your business? This should all be tied together by the performance management or the strategy management framework. Now, the whole point of this is that all of these are siloed usually in any large organization. And the faster the organization grows, the more siloed all of this becomes. So when it comes to the top management, there's complete duplication and lack of single source of data. So I have been at meetings where a sales number or revenue number, cost number, different departments have a different number. Because one is coming from Oracle, one is coming from the timesheeting system, one is coming from something else. So there's no single source of truth.